Despite George's enthusiastic sexual enterprise, he had only produced one legitimate child, and she died in childbirth. The heir to the throne was his brother William, who was 54. He had been sent into the Navy as a young man, where he developed into a severe disciplinarian and a stickler for etiquette. After he left, he took an actress, Mrs. Jordan, as his mistress, had lots of illegitimate children, and was given to making tactless speeches with not much intelligence. He eventually had made a royal marriage to another German Protestant princess, and Mr. King and Mrs. Queen lived at Bushey to the north of London, like a quite ordinary couple. William insisted that his coronation should only cost a tenth of his brother's, and he was known to give people a lift in his carriage. All this made him rather popular, but when it came to parliamentary reform, he turned out to be as resistant as any other Hanoverian king. By now, the popular pressure for changing the voting system into something more representative was virtually irresistible, giving more men the vote, having MPs for the new towns and secret ballots. This would give the Commons more power, so the House of Lords was resisting it, and William sided with them. By 1832, there seemed a real possibility of civil war or revolution. It's possible that if the royal family were part of the aristocracy, as in every other country with a king, that would have happened. But the king and queen had their family roots in Germany, and there was no natural alliance between them and the great aristocratic families. William was weak and was forcefully persuaded to give way, and Britain was started on the road to democracy. After the Reform Bill of 1832, with no more rotten boroughs and greatly reduced scope for electoral corruption, it was no longer possible for the king to play politics inside Parliament to the same extent. The monarchy would now be forced back into its constitutional box, and it was no longer sufficiently dangerous to be worth the trouble of a revolution. When he died in 1837, William's legitimate children were already dead. The heir to the throne was the daughter of his brother Edward, a young girl of 18.